I suppose 9/11 is more than mere numerology now. It's an icon that will be forever etched in our minds and memories, and indeed in our hearts, particularly in the hearts of our children.
At 8:46 a.m. on September 11, 2001, the world changed drastically. It seemed such a picture-perfect, glorious New York day. Children got off to school. Workers and shopkeepers prepared to do business. Commuters made their way into the city. The streets of my Central Harlem neighborhood, near 125th Street, were abuzz with life. Actually, things could not have looked better. I began my daily subway commute into Lower Manhattan. Everything seemed so routine. Yes, the world changed radically that morning. And this is a story about how that moment personally affected my life. Yet, it's as much your story as mine. You see, it's about time, perhaps our most precious common commodity, a gift we all share. Between birth and death, each of us has choices. We can celebrate life or live in the shadows of cynicism and fear. Or we can seek to build what Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. referred to as the beloved community. A gift we all share. It's about hope, healing, and the search for meaning in life.
Suddenly, hordes of people just began to run maddeningly along this platform. And in the emotional contagion of it all, I began to run as well, not knowing what was happening. I thought maybe a madman was loose, or someone had a gun and gone berserk or something. But people were pushing one another. And my fear was that I was going to be pushed onto the platform. I didn't know whether I should run in this direction, whether I should run. And I'm standing there with my neck craned, and that's when the second plane hit. And that's when I knew that we were under attack or it was something very unusual had occurred.
I remember the imagery of feet and legs flailing as though swimming or riding a tricycle or bicycle as fast as they could, with the legs spinning faster and faster. This is the artist's depiction of what I saw on that day. Journalists and social critics would begin to ask the painful questions of why this happened. Prior to that, many of the images had been shrouded in patriotism and in unifying our nation and our people around the war narrative.
And we need to act with massive power, in my view, without a lot of collateral damage, and that's difficult to do. But this is an act of war, and we need to act accordingly. Now is the time to step up to the plate and do the things that we need to do here as a country.
At this hour in this war,
we cannot be a tape paper tiger. This act, in my view, it wasn't coincidence.
We're at war. We're absolutely at war. This is 21st century war.
We have some laws on our books that we ought to take a look at. One of them is simply a presidential executive order that says the United States doesn't go out and assassinate people.
Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? All on that day, will I run to the rock? Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me, Lord, all on that day.
As I ran for my very life through the winding canyons that intersect Fulton and Day Streets, literally yards away from the World Trade Center, it became clear to me what I should do with the balance of my life. anthrax.
Well, this prompted incredible scares around the country because people didn't know whether they would be next. How many of these letters were out there? Would they get something in their mail that might be impacted with the anthrax too?
In the end, 5 people died, 18 people were confirmed infected, and whoever was trying to do this, if they were trying to kill lots of people, they failed miserably. And we proved to ourselves that this infection was something that we could get a handle on. We could treat people. 30,000 people were on antibiotics at one time or another, but we beat that.
Breaking news this evening. The FBI is warning of more potential attacks against the United States.
While not specific as to target, gives the government reason to believe that there may be additional terrorist attacks within the United States.
Traces of anthrax have been found in at least 4 more post offices. Officials
are stranded there.
Told Vice President Dick Cheney being kept apart from the president again, just in case the White House is a target of a terrorist strike.
The enemy is resourceful and ruthless. We have to assume there will be more attacks.
Officials were very scared that there would be another attack. And there was a long laundry list of different sectors that they wanted to protect. Aviation, it goes without saying, a lot of attention paid there. But they were also concerned about nuclear plants, about chemical plants, about the ports, which are hugely vulnerable, about the borders, which are very porous.
We urge Americans in the course of their normal activities to remain alert and to report unusual circumstances or inappropriate behavior.
Everybody is concerned about what's going to happen next.
You just feel so vulnerable now because you don't know what's going to happen, where it's going to happen.
A lot of people are afraid. They're scared.
It's overwhelming, the whole thought of it, the devastation.
In those days after the terrorist attack, we began to see terrorists on every corner and believe that they had an overwhelming ability to strike our nation.
In the name of Homeland Security, Attorney General John Ashcroft is asking law enforcement officials nationwide to interview some 5,000 people currently here on temporary visas.
We have in detention about 563 individuals who are being detained on Immigration and Naturalization Service items related to the events of 9/11.
Pakistan was a reasonably safe haven for terrorists.
We celebrate Christmas in a time of testing with American troops far from home.
Today, the fires are finally out. The Taliban have been driven from power. Their leaders are on the run.
And this is a year we will not forget. Those who lost loved ones in the attacks on September the 11th and on the battlefield, they will remain in our prayers.
I want to tell you that my husband is a hero, not because of the way that he died, but rather because of the way that he lived.
I found myself at a loss for words. I still do when I think about this.